on this whole issue of the push as we speak right now to amend the Constitution. Yeah. What is your view on this attempt to amend the 2010 Constitution?
Well, first, I don't know what is being amended. Right?
Would you like to be amended? It to be amended?
But you must know first what is being amended.
It's not before. Like there are some people out there coming to amend it. It's Kenyans like you. Would you like it to see it amended? That is a fair question.
You know, Joe, that's not a very fair question.
No, it
you
is.
Know, you're putting the cart before the horse. I mean, what are the issues? What are we trying to deal with? To the best of my knowledge, this whole push is being pushed by leaders. It's not being pushed by the public, by the people. The people at this moment in time, and I engage with many of them, the people are concerned about their jobs. They have lost jobs. They have lost livelihoods. They are concerned about their children. They are concerned about what they will eat. At this point in time, they are concerned about this corona. Where is it going to end? There seems to be no end in sight. That is their concern. That's the concern of many people. And I would wish that those of us who are in leadership can plug into that conversation where Kenyans are thinking about their livelihoods. Unfortunately, many of us are concerned more about how we are going to rearrange the Constitution so that we can, I don't know, create some positions. You know, this thing about changing the Constitution is very weird. We went to Bomas. The first draft was brought to us. And everybody said, fine. If this is the document, we have absolutely no problem with it, because largely it presented issues that were to be implemented, administrative issues, policy issues, and not much, right? And we all agreed. But then, I don't know who complained, because I have never had anybody who complained about the document. But somehow, the document was taken back. And now we are waiting. So we don't know whether it will come the way it was, or whether it is. Do you have a clue of what could be in this thing?
I think the president does, because yesterday he actually said this is the time to amend the Constitution.
Yes.
He spent a good part of his speech yesterday speaking about the need to amend the Constitution. So I'm finding it very strange that...
There is nothing strange. You see...
I'm finding it very strange that where you sit, you actually think it is not a priority, that the priority is delivery of services to the people and all of these things. You are in the same party with the president. You ran on the same platform. I would imagine that you're... policy priorities would be the same at this point. It clearly is not, because
are you aware, Joe, that the only political party who did not have a position in the BBI is Jubilee? Are you aware that there was no position that was presented to BBI that came from Jubilee as a party? Because it is not a matter we discussed in the party. Right? And I am not saying what you're saying. What I'm saying is maybe, just maybe, when this document is finally unveiled, it will have some things that would actually persuade us that it is a priority at the moment. And then maybe we can persuade the people that yes, your priority could be food, could be your job, could be your business, could be your child going to school. But we have another priority here, you know? And the Constitution is a social contract. It is between the governed and the governors, right? So it's not something for us to decide as government. right?
You'd understand my dilemma.
It is something that has to be worked out, right? Between Kenyans, you know, between Kenyans. It's not a government position that we are taking a position as government.
So you are saying, Dr. Ruto, that the things that the president has been saying, neither Jubilee position nor government position, those are his personal views as Uhuru Kenyatta.
Well, I don't know about that, but the best of my knowledge, we have never had a meeting as Jubilee to discuss, right, about our position in changing the constitution.
That being an important issue that it is your philosophy, you said, yet we haven't seen you give those views to the BBI, which at this moment, that task force, is supposedly the one that is going to bring the report that could be taken to a referendum that could determine how this constitutional issue is settled. How is it that these views that you hold so strongly haven't been shared with this task force?
Joe, one, we haven't presented to the task force a party position. I would have canvassed.
That's a personal view, and there are individuals who've presented.
I would have canvassed my position. And I have pushed for my position using other avenues into the BBI, the conversation. As to whether they will take them up or not is a different story.
So you have spoken to the BBI team?
Not directly, but I have made sure that they have, those views are part of what they have